Happily, however, we are informed by our prophetic leaders that notwithstanding our wrong political philosophy, our moral decay, the kingdom of God, which is the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, will survive. For this is the dispensation of the fullness of times. A great many Latter-day Saints will fail. A great many of them are not now and never have been living up to their privileges and magnifying their college, their callings, and their priesthood. And God will have a reckoning with such people. The spread of effeminacy, girls looking and acting like men, men looking and acting like girls, disregard of religion. Do you recognize any of these symptoms in the United States today?
There are certain crimes and offensive conduct which will this year bring immediate suspension from this university. In general, these are offenses involving moral turpitude, such as adultery or fornication or other breaches of the Mormon moral code. Nor do we intend to admit to our campus any homosexuals. If any of you have this tendency and have not completely abandoned it, may I suggest that you leave the campus immediately after this assembly, and if you will be honest enough to let us know the reason, we will refund your tuition. We do not want others on this campus to be contaminated by your presence.
What message do you have for the LGBT young single adults? I want anyone who is a member of the church, who is gay or lesbian, to know I believe you have a place in the kingdom and recognize that sometimes it may be difficult for you to see where you fit in the Lord's church, but you do. We need to listen to and understand what our LGBT brothers and sisters are feeling and experiencing. Certainly, we must do better than we have done in the past so that all members feel they have a spiritual home where their brothers and sisters love them and where they have a place to worship and serve the Lord. Certainly, we must do better than we have done in the past